Welcome to Freedive Live, episode number 16. My name is Ted Harty. I'm the founder of Immersion Freediving as well as freedivingsafety.com. If you have not visited freedivingsafety.com, you definitely should. It's a free online resource that goes over the risks of the sport, the truth about blackout. They're going to talk about the fatality numbers in the sport. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. You're going to learn how to tell if you are overweighted. You're going to learn how to tell if you are breathing in a way that would increase your risk of blackout. And ultimately, the most important thing you're going to learn is what to do if your buddy has a loss of motor control or a blackout, right? So if that's not enough to make you visit the program, visit the website, if you pass the quiz, and I made it hard, but if you pass the quiz, you're going to get discounts from nine of some of the biggest names in the sport. So learn to save your buddy, save yourself, or save some money. Either way, there's no reason not to visit freedivingsafety.com. All right, so today's game plan for today is I'm going to be going over tips for static apnea. I've got some really cool footage that I'm going to show you guys towards the end of me actually doing, this was in 2012, during the Performance Freediving Deja Blu competition, and it's, I ended up winning that competition, and I did a static of 601, which for me is my, is to date, is my actually personal comp PB, and I actually beat that, my PB, by about 30 seconds. So go over just some general tips for static apnea, what I did in that, that event to do what I did. All right, what's up? Someone's there on YouTube. So for those of you who are tuning in, I'm crazy delayed about 45 minutes because I am not a technical person and I want to strangle my camera and the connections and all sorts of stuff I won't bore you with, but that's why the show was delayed. Anyway. So let's go over the game plan, or go over what we're going to start with. One thing I'll tell you for those that are tuning in, I see people are coming in chat via YouTube. What I'm always interested in is where you're from, and then let me know if you've seen the show before, right? Because I'm always curious to find out, is this new people that are watching the show or people that have seen it before? So if you've seen the show, if you're watching right now in the comments, let me know if you have seen the show before, and also let me know where you're from. All right, so one of the quick things we'll do before we get into the nitty-gritty is if you are watching and you are interested in learning how to get better at static apnea, one of the simplest things you can do is visit onlinefreedivingcourses.com. One of the first things when you get there, you're gonna you get a free course on how to take a bigger breath. Right, so the idea is if you want to improve your static, put more fuel in there. So the idea is that will teach you how to take a 20 to 30% bigger breath, and if you want to increase your bottom time, increase your static, that's going to be the first place you do it. All right, so let's talk about tips for static apnea. So static is isn't that fun? I mean, let's think about what we're doing here. We're trying to hold our breath as long as humanly possible. You're going to see in the video that I'm going to show you guys at the end that, you know, that was an example where I went right to the edge, right, where I was kind of not there. But it was able to made it. Excellent. So someone started the 28-day transformation program. That's super cool. Make sure you join the Facebook group. If you haven't gone through and watched all the videos, I know I'm forcing you to watch them in order, so you have to watch the safety stuff first. I'm just that way. At some point down the end, you're going to get instructions for how to join the Facebook group. So definitely, if you have Facebook, I would do that. It's a nice bonus. It's a way for us to interact. I can answer your questions, and you get to meet all the other students. All right, so tips for static apnea. Static apnea is, it's not fun. I mean, it's not. You're going to hold your breath, it hurts, and you're going to hold your breath some more. So you got to have the right mindset to do static. I will tell you, I guess it was 2 years ago, I've taken some time off from competing because it's hard work. I'd rather train the young whippersnappers to do it. They do better than me anyway. It was a couple years ago, and I was getting, you know, I wouldn't say super serious, but I was getting serious about training, and I was doing static apnea in my pool. I've got a nice pool out there, and I was doing statics with Kathy, my girlfriend, and, you know, she's gone through the program. I trust her to safety me, certainly for statics. And there's times when I'm out there, and it's, you know, I personally am not not that good at statics. I mean, you think if I do a 6 minute static, that must mean I'm really good at it. But one, that's actually not that long for people that dive as deep as I do. And that was a one time comp PB. Most comps I'm doing 5, 5:30. That's certainly not my area of expertise. So I'll be out there training, and you know, 3 minutes, 3:30, I'm just having contractions. And in my mind, I'm thinking, this is the dumbest sport. Like I could be on the golf course right now. I could be on the golf course. I could be like having some cute girl come up to me and give me a beer. And like, here I am like shoving my face underwater until like, you know, try to hold my breath, I almost pass out. So sometimes, and there's times like that when I would just quit. Like I quit at 3 minutes, 4 minutes. I come by and just like, I can't do this because I don't have the right mindset, right? Then maybe I come back 2 days later. Then I come back 2 days later and then my mindset is good and I'm fired up to do the static. And then, you know, maybe I get a personal best or I do an awesome breath hold and I come up and I'm just like, yes, like this is awesome, right? So if you have the wrong mindset, you're not going to do well. So what is the right mindset? One of the hardest things, so I do a lot of work with Nathan as an athlete that's watching that I've done some training with. He's a past student of mine. He's an instructor, and he is very into competitive freediving and is doing very well. One of the hardest things I have to get across to, whether it's my students in class or an athlete, maybe like Nate, actually Nate really doesn't have this issue. He seems to get this part sorted, is if you want to hold your breath a long time, the less you care about how long you hold your breath, the better you'll do. And there won't be any, you know, instructor or competitor that will disagree with that. We tend to be very numbers focused and goals focused. And that just is terrible strategy for free diving. So first off, get your mind, if you're doing statics, right, you should be thinking about it as training for like, you know, future statics. So you check the box, you get credit for getting there and doing a breath hold, right? So whether you do a bad one or a good one, you get some credit for doing it. So just take that pressure off you and you're going to do much better. I see that in the 28-day freediving program, the Facebook group, people get, sometimes they get frustrated, they have a bad day, and then they get pissed off, and the next day they do worse, and the next day they do worse, and that's all because what's going on between the ears. But as far as some basic things for static apnea, especially because I get a lot of people that are new, especially the 20-day program, they've never taken a class. They really are new to the whole process. Generally speaking, you need to find out when work time works best for you. Most people tend to do better in the morning. Not everyone, most people do. Try doing statics at different times, and you'll find out what you're best at. Most people are going to do better eating less. Right, you're not gonna have any advantage by having a huge meal. You're gonna want to eat either none or, I mean, like if it's a competition environment, you're gonna be eating, you know, very little or and certainly not right before the event. Coffee, most people are gonna tell you it ain't gonna help. So you know, those are just a couple things. But the main thing is, if you're doing some sort of regular training, you just need to find out what time works for you. I see a lot of people that are in the 28-day program talk about how they do bad if they do it in the afternoon or if they do it after they come home from work. No, they do bad. They just do worse than if they do it when they wake up first thing in the morning. But obviously everyone's routine and whatnot is different, and some people aren't that super concerned about holding their breath before they go to work, which I totally understand. But if you're in a training, it can make a difference, is your time. All right, so what I'm going to do here is before I pull up the video, I'll kind of give a little backstory about what was going on during the breath hold and beforehand. Also, for any of you that are watching, if you have questions, put them in the comments. I will have some time at the end where I'll be able to answer some of your questions. So if you have comments, I always say, like, you know, unless your roommate is a freediving instructor with 10 years of experience, I would imagine there's something rattling around in your brain that you're not quite sure about when it comes to freediving. And now is an excellent opportunity to put those questions in the comments, and I will start answering them. So during this static, it was the Deja Blue competition, performer freediving puts on. They're doing a training camp actually right now in Cayman. It's awesome. One of the single best things you can do for your freediving. Nate would agree. I was trying to win the competition, and I ended up winning the competition. But when you're in a competition like that, there's six different events. There's three pool events. There's three ocean events. And so that's six events. You get points in each event. So there's actually a good bit of strategy on like what you need to do to, you know, because you got to get good in everything. For those of you that don't know, if you're in a freediving competition, for instance, in this video that you see, I came close to having a blackout. And if I had a blackout, I'd get 0 points. Right. So getting a zero is bad. If you're trying to put together 6 points, I mean, six scores across six events, right? You get a zero, you're done. So I went into the competition, into this static event. My coach was Francesca, a good friend of mine. She's been involved in the sport a long time. And, oh, is that Matt? Been involved in the sport for a long time. And so I told her, I said, look, Francesca, I'm doing really good. I just need to get, like, my static will be, I just need to do, like, 5:30, right? Like, if I do 5:30, I'm fine. I'm going to do good in the competition. I don't need to go crazy. So the main thing, Francesca, is just don't let me black out. Don't let me have a loss of motor control. And don't let me go past 5:30 no matter what. Like, I don't need to. All I need to do is 5:30 and it'll be fine. And I should be a good place to win the competition. So that was the kind of game plan. But the plan changed. Well, I'll let you see the video kind of to see what happened. We'll watch the video now. All right, so let me do my techno wizardry stuff and see if I can make this work. No. Holy cow, there it is. So this is me getting ready for the static. That is a technique called packing that competitive freedivers use that put more air in the lungs. If you are not know what you're doing, stay the hell away from this technique. You can absolutely injure yourself and actually kill yourself if you don't know what you're doing. So anyway, so that's me starting my breath holds. I'm going down and just focus, obviously, on being nice and relaxed, right? So Francesca's my coach. Okay, so this is me getting near the end of the breath hold. Now, if you look, you can see I'm having some contractions. See my shoulders going? That's Francesca lowering her head saying, hey, you should come up. It's 5:30 and I'm shaking my head going, nope, I'm not gonna. She's stressed because she said I was supposed to come up at 5:30. So you can see the contractions are getting harder. I'm shaking my head going, no, Francesca, I'm not coming up. So she's stressed out because I'm doing exactly, I told her, make me come up at 5:30. So what happened is I actually felt amazing at the beginning of the breath hold, and I knew I was going to do a really good one, and I was going to go a lot longer. So I was trying to tell her by shaking my head that, hey, I'm fine. I know I told you to come up at 5:30, but I'm just not going to. All right, so I want to pause this right here. So for those of you that might not know a lot about competitive freediving, when we come up, we have 15.00 seconds to do three things. I have to take my mask off, or take whatever's on your face off. In my case, I had goggles and a nose clip, right? So it was almost messed me up. I had to take the goggles off, got to take the nose clip off. You have to look at the judge and give the okay sign, which is defined as thumb touching middle finger, or thumb touching this finger, or really any finger. Any one of those are okays according to the judges. And you have to say the words, I am okay, or I'm okay in English. Those three things in order in 15 seconds. Gear off, okay sign, I'm okay. In order in 15.0 seconds. If you take your stuff off, say I'm okay, and you go like that, you did out of order, you get a zero. Right, and the premise is they're trying to make sure, like, we can't have people coming up from a static and have a loss of motor control and black out, and they're like, "Woo, that was awesome! He broke the record and wins the competition!" Right? The sport wants us to come up clean and have good dives, and so the way that they judge that is that you do those three things in order in 15.0 seconds. Now, you're going to see from this video that when I come up, I really don't know what my name is or what planet I'm on. Now, part of the rules is I can have a coach, and Francesca was and is an awesome coach. So when she comes up, she is telling me what to do. because I don't really know what to do. I think I take my mask off, but I think I take that stuff off. And I think maybe she has to tell me they're okay, but she has to tell me to say I'm okay like two or three times. You can see in the background going, say you're okay, right? Because if I don't get it done, I'm going to get a zero. All right, so for those of you that don't know competitive freediving, this part maybe will make a little bit more sense. So I'll put the video back on. All right, so I'm doing my six recovery breaths. So yeah, so I remember I'm pretty sure I do six because I'm kind of hardwired to do that. So one, two, three, four, five. Okay, so that stuff's off. She's telling me to give the okay sign. I don't know what my name is. Now, what's funny is I say I'm okay probably two or three more times because I'm not totally aware of what's going on yet. I say it again. That's three times. All right, now I'm like, oh, my name's Ted. I'm doing a static competition. So now I'm just waiting for the judges to say what I got. And now I'm like, okay, but how long do I hold my breath for? I don't really remember what happened. And I had no idea that I held my breath for 6 minutes because I wasn't super aware of what was happening. Anyway. So that was an example of having a really good coach was really useful because if she was not screaming at me to say those things, no way I would have passed that. No way I would have passed that. So definitely having a good coach is super, super useful. Now, a question I get asked a lot is, what do you think about during statics? I'll tell you what, one of the reasons I did really well in that particular breath hold, and well, there are a lot of reasons I did well, but one of them I do think was what I was thinking. I'll tell you what I did with that particular example, which is unusual and probably not super able to for you to redo. But I've been playing music all my life, guitar, piano, bass, some bass, some drums. I'm learning to play harmonica. I'm a musician. I've always done that, right? And so when I have dreams about music. I can actually have dreams about a guitar song, and I can wake it up and play it like in the morning because that's when my brain works. So I'm a huge Russ fan. My favorite band. I saw them probably 14, 15 times in concert. And I had this awesome dream the night before the static, and the dream was I got. Something happened to Alex Lifeson, the guitar player, and they were doing auditions for a guitar player, and I ended up in the audition, right? So here I am in my dream. I'm auditioning for Rush. And so, you know, they asked me, like, you know, all right, show me what you got, right? And then I was playing, like, you know, my most badass guitar song I can play, right? And they were like, oh, my God, it's amazing. And they're like, show me what kind of Rush songs you got. So then I was going through the Rush repertoire. And so, you know, and then, you know, I got the job, and then in the dream, we were like practicing the sets, right? So we were going through particular songs, you know, I was doing the guitar solo, all this stuff. Anyway, so this dream was like the best dream I've ever had, because it's like my dream to like be played for Rush. And so anyway, when I'm doing the statics, I am absolutely replaying that entire dream, and the dream was so awesome that it was like, you know, if I felt like I was like watching my doing my static, I feel like I'm replaying or watching my favorite TV show where like I'm the superstar of this Rush thing. So I was totally, totally engrossed. I could, you know, I was remembering the guitar solos that I played. I was remembering the song that I played. So I can't imagine any better mental place for someone to be when they're doing statics. Now, is that super, and like, can you do that when you're doing static? Well, you didn't have a dream about Rush and whatever, you probably can't do that. So here's some kind of general advice I give. A lot of people, and I'm not, you know, I'll tell you certain things that I've heard and that people do. What I will tell you is, this is an excellent question to ask people, right? I always, if I ever am around competitive freediveers, I always like to ask them, what do you think about? And you're going to get a lot of different answers because there's definitely not like a correct answer. It's not like people go, oh, well, absolutely, you're an idiot if you don't do this. So you got to kind of find out what works for you. I think a lot of people, beginners, play distraction games. You can try that. I'm not the biggest fan. When I say distraction games, I'd say like pick a the first letter of the alphabet A and make a word in A, and then pick the second letter of the alphabet B and then make a word, and they do that. I think a lot of things that people think about are categorized as a distraction games. I've never been a big fan of that, but you can. That's certainly one thing to think about. One thing I used to do for a long time, and you might argue that it's just another form of distraction game, but for some reason I find it's different, is, and I had learned this from Kirk years and years ago, was to think through your waking up, right? Like, what did you do in the morning, right? And so when I started, when I first heard Kirk say that, I was like doing a static, and I'm like, okay, that seems kind of stupid. But then I'm like, okay, so I'm like doing my static. Okay, so I woke up and I took a shower and I ate breakfast and I took a shower and I, you know, got my clothes on and I ate breakfast and I got in the car and 30 seconds of my breath hold, I was already like 2 hours through the day. And, you know, his point was like, no, like that's not the way it works. Like, you want to, like, it's like, all right, I woke up, I remember the alarm going off, and I remember being like, sweet, I hit the snooze button, I went back to sleep, and I remember having this little crazy dream about whatever. I woke up the second time, and I said, I still hit the snooze button, and I went back to sleep. And the third time I woke up, and I remember getting up, putting my feet on the floor, and Sammy's dog toys were all in the way, and I had to kick him out of the way, and I, you know, stumbled into the room, and I went to the bathroom, and then I remember I was thinking about the, right, so the idea is, like, you're really taking things slowly, so, I mean, by the time that I'm 2 minutes into my static, like, I'm not even in the shower yet, right, so that is something that I used to use, and found helpful. You can try that and see. I would say what a lot of, if you're really interested in that sort of thing, right? Like if you're a competitor, you're trying to do better at statics, certainly if you're a spear fisherman, you're not going to do this, or it doesn't apply to you. This is what I'm talking about, is definitely applying to people that are doing static. You look at a lot of high level competitors, they almost all do some form of meditation. I've done a little bit of that. I worked with Sarah Campbell, and I think that was helpful. It's not something I train a lot, but even when I do statics, I can use that to my advantage. And it's just, you know, it's just simply just you tune it out and think of nothing and not. And I find that to be very helpful. But those are, you know, different things you can do. What I would tell you, ultimately, it's... Okay, so this is actually a pretty good comment. I'll bring this up. So Jeremy Gamble, the owner of Spearing Magazine, said, the second you say 2 minutes, I start contracting. So it's funny that you say that, because you ain't the first student I've seen say that. In fact, I was training someone, and I can't remember who this was. This was years ago. And he was talking about that. And he's like, I hold my breath for 2 minutes, I have contractions. And I was trying to tell him that there's no way that every time you hold your breath after 120 seconds, you have a contraction. I absolutely believe when I say the words 2 minutes, you have a contraction, because your brain says, shit, that's 2 minutes, I'm having a contraction. So I had this person that was having this argument with, and so I said, okay, well, you know, and so, and then when we did like the third rounds of static, I just didn't say 2 minutes and until 2 minutes and 30 seconds. As soon as I said 2 minutes, he had a contraction. He was like, see? I'm like, actually, I didn't say that until 2 minutes and 30 seconds. So see, right? So a lot of it is with statics is definitely... I've never seen a sport that has nothing to do with, and more to do with what's between your ears, right? Static apnea, you're sitting there hurting yourself on purpose. You got to get your brain sorted to make that work. Anyway, without me around, right? So static training is not a lot of fun, right? I mean, so here's a weird thing to look at. The whole sport is crazy. Like static apnea, I mean, like, let's think about the sport. Look at that video of me, right? So if you go to freedom competition, we're doing static apnea, it's the weirdest thing ever, right? You're going to see people face down, right? And you're going to see people hold their breath, and then they come up, and they're going to take a couple of breaths, and they're going to black out. And everyone goes, oh, he went too long. Oh, he didn't make it, right? And so Uh-oh. Might be able to fix this. Trying, bear with me, guys. And if I can't fix it, it's going to be the end of the show. Tell me the camera. Oh my God, it's still working. Holy cow. All right. Clearly, I have technical issues I need to get sorted out. All right. I need to make it focus. All right. If there's anyone out there who is interested in living in my office, I've got a little tiny office here, and if you would be interested in living in here, and just, I don't need you to do anything other than at like 6 o'clock, just make all this work so I can walk in and talk, let's talk, because all this stuff drives me insane, and I'm not very good at it. But anyway, if we go back to what I was saying, is this is why competitive freediving is the craziest sport ever, right? You go to freediving competition, you're going to see people black out, and they're going to go, oh, he didn't make it, and then you're going to see people come up early, right, where they're pissed off because they can't have they're smart enough to come up early. When they come up and they're mad because they didn't hold their breath long enough. And then someone like that video you saw of me where I come up and I'm like right on the verge of having a blackout, but I don't. Everyone's like, yeah, it was awesome, right? They came this close to blackout, but he didn't do it. Woo, right? That's a weird sport, right? It's a weird sport, right? There's no getting around it. Hey, we don't need to be talking about stuff like that. But yeah, so if you guys have any questions, I'll put them in there. Otherwise, I'm going to wrap this thing up with a technical snafu. But yeah, if you guys have questions, put them in there. If not, I'm going to put this puppy to bed. For those of you that are interested and learning more techniques to hold your breath, if you go to onlinefreedivingcourses.com, one of the first... So the first thing you do is you'll sign up for the free course to learn to take a 20 or 30% bigger breath. And then the next thing you're going to see is my breath holding secrets program, right? So this is $39. It goes over the biggest secret into holding your breath, which is basically, it's not what you do during the breath hold, it's what you do before the breath hold. So it's only $39 when you get the course. You're going to get access to the breath holding secrets. You're going to get access to freedivingsafety.com. You're going to get access to TED Talks Freediving Greatest Hits. I have 20 hours of the old show, TED Talks Freediving, and I know you have no interest in listening to me talk for 20 hours, but I paid a freediving instructor to watch all 20 of those, and then he pulled out the best hour. And so basically the best information. And then this is a video I did for Spearing Magazine, how to activate your mammalian dive reflex. And then I also have a video from Ashley, which is she's a 3-time world record holder, and has 14 national records, right? So go through and you get all that stuff. It's $49. And then some of you guys may have heard about the 28-day program, which is my training program where you learn 5 of the best dry land training exercises you can do at home. If you go through and you purchase that Breath Hold Secrets program, it'll take you to the 28-day program. Basically, the way that website works is some people, you know, they don't want the 28-day program. They're new. They just want to get started with the Breath Hold Secrets. It's only $39. But once you purchase that, it will give you the option to purchase the 28-day program. And if you have just purchased the Breath Hold Secrets program for $39, it's going to take $39 off the price of the 28-day program. 28-day program is $149, but the Breath Hold Secrets is included. And I'm going to just make this thing go away because the camera went out again and I'm frustrated. So I will be back next week. I won't be doing one Thursday. I'll be back. It'll be next week. And I have a big announcement to make with that, but I can't make it yet because it hasn't been announced. But I will see you guys on Monday, and hopefully I'll have hired someone to live in my office and make sure all of this runs smoothly so I can just sit in this chair and talk about freediving, because that's what I'm good at. Technical stuff, I'm not good at. All right, see you guys. Dive face up, dive safe out there. It's not even that hard, considering you can go to freedivingsafety.com and learn how to not kill yourself for free. See you guys.